Do you have any idea about how big earned media is in the pie? I mean, that's
in
kind of a
the,
big number.
In
I mean,
terms of the in terms of the total volume of
volume or
activity.
Budget or any metrics around the size of earned media or where it's going?
So, in terms of volume, I would say, you know, the tonnage is in billions of views. We see, because we see the entire footprint of brand video content that's out there across several hundred publishers, what we are seeing is 55 different vertical categories in which campaigns are run by literally hundreds of brands out there. So that tonnage, I don't know how that compares with the broader consumption of volume, and I'm not really comparing that with pre-roll or in-stream video, because that's not where we actually play. We play in where the brands create the content for the experience itself, which is usually a non-standard unit, which rises above 30 seconds and goes all the way to 8 minutes or 10 minutes long, essentially, right?
Molly, what is your take on this?
Well, I'm, you know, obviously there's tremendous value in brands getting involved in creating web-exclusive content. I think, you know, with the exception of the Dove spot, which I believe ran on TV, and maybe the Roller Babies in a shorter form, you know, a lot of these videos were created for the web. I know we spoke earlier about the outtakes from the Force video for Volkswagen, which, you know, did extremely well. It wouldn't have ever run on TV. I think the issue there that brands have to realize is they see things like the Roller Babies, they see things like Old Spice, and they're like, we can do that too. And, you know, that's just not always the case, which is sometimes the brand message, it just doesn't work in that type of environment, because you're at that point, you're creating entertaining content. You're not just surrounding the content with your message. You are the content. And, you know, so again, and I don't know exactly how you're measuring and what you're calling earned media, but we know, and it's something that marketers don't talk about too much, which is that many of the top viral videos that are on the Ad Age viral chart and those are paid for. Mm-hmm. You know, you can pay for social action online. So I'm not saying that it doesn't still have the impact of, hey, if it gets spread on Facebook, but there's somebody at the back going, check this out. You know, so there it's more than just like organically sprouting up from the ground.
Well, mm-hmm. so that's a very interesting point, right? What Molly brings up in that, what does it mean to have earned media? What is earned media?
Right, it's not called free media. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it is not. Well, so to have earned media, there is no theoretical purity associated with that. It's at the end of the day, brands getting their message out there. You have to pay to promote your video in all of the right places where the consumers can discover. So that's the paid component of that. But whatever incremental comes by sharing around, making multiplicity of copies of those or derivative content and so forth that goes out there, and what that generates in terms of views is what we term as earned media. So essentially, truly, honest to goodness, the users are spreading the message, right? And they'll only do that if it's compelling content. But let's not in any way feel, sense, or think that this is very easy to do. It appears easy when you see Old Spice out there or Avian Babies out there, but there is a lot of art and science associated with that, both in terms of the type of content you create, what and how you message that, how that becomes compelling enough for users to want to share, the length of the content, the duration, all of that, plus the media science behind that in terms of whether you front-load the media, mm-hmm. back-load the media, and how you tease it and all that other stuff. There is amazing amount of science in there. And I think it's data.
You look exhausted.
No, it's data that gives you advantage in this kind of a medium if you really want to do it right. Absolutely, it's true. For the media agencies who've been working with us and who've been very helpful, of course, in guiding us all the way through, for them, it's amazing. It's very interesting. They get really into that. I've never seen media agencies get that excited about data. But I think that's really what it is. That's what powers this medium forward. You know?